centre tonight. On calendar, it's Barcelona. Leeds United's third date with Stuttgart has been set for Friday night, and outraged fans say they're being penalised for Leeds' innocence.
Friday night at 8:15 is the time. Barcelona is the place. The wise men of UEFA met in Switzerland today to determine where round three of the battle between Leeds United and Stuttgart should take place.
Coming up later, but of course, all Yorkshire eyes tonight are on the Nou Camp Stadium in Barcelona. And our man in the stadium is Nick Powell. Nick, good evening.
Good evening, Christopher. And what a stadium it is, as you see me. The Nou Camp Stadium is used to holding 120,000 people. It won't, of course, be that full tonight, but it'll be full, certainly, of emotion, I'm sure, for the Leeds fans who thought they were out of the European Cup just 9 days ago. And now some of them made this long journey across the Channel to get here at very short notice. More of them later, but first the match. Here's Brendan Foley.
There's no mistaking the determination in the Leeds camp or in the manager's appraisal of the task confronting his players.
They've earned the right to be here tomorrow night. They've earned the right to have another chance to go into the next round. I think the prize is a big prize. Sometimes in life, you know, you can't just live for the minute and live for what other people say about you. You've got to aim for the future, and the future is the European Cup.
Tonight is one game where Wilkinson's famous motivational skills will hardly be necessary.
We're feeling good, you know, as I've said before, we were at the tournament, now we're back in. Hopefully we can go on.
There's no knowing, if only they believe in themselves and believe in what I tell them, there's no knowing what they can do.
Here's the man Wilkinson hopes to emulate next May, Barcelona coach Johan Cruyff, who won the European Cup for the Pride of Catalonia last season. So the stage is set in Spain, and tonight, one way or another, Leeds' destiny in Europe's Premier Cup competition will be settled once and for all.
And of course, you will be able to see it live on ITV, the programme presented by Ian St John, who's here now. Long walk out, wasn't it?
Oh, yes. You get a nosebleed up here, don't you? I'll tell you what, the people at home watching on television get a great view. Up here, you need binoculars. They go so high up, aren't they?
How important is it to British football for Leeds to win tonight?
Well, very important for English football, but don't forget the winners play Glasgow Rangers. Right. So, I mean, you've got to think that the Scots will want Rangers to win that one. But it will set up some tie, you know, a British Championship tie. So it's very important, obviously, that Leeds won. But I think it's important because of the fact that the way that they were supposedly out the tournament anyway, I mean, the Germans transgressed the rules and should really have been out, as far as we're concerned, as Brits. But there you are, we're getting another bite at it.
In a sentence, where's your money?
I think Leeds will do it.
And you haven't had a time, have you, you've come late, your plane was delayed, you haven't actually had a chance to look around this wonderful city, have you?
No, it's a beauty, isn't it? Lovely city.
Terrific. I've had a little bit of a look around the city today. The city, of course, that was made so famous just a couple of months ago by the Olympic Games. A city that not many Leeds fans have seen.
Well, obviously, we seem to have a bit of a problem with that report. We'll try and get it in a moment. But it gives me the opportunity, I suppose, to have a chat with Nick and ask him how things are going. It seems to be a very exciting atmosphere over there, Nick.
It's exciting, certainly, in the town centre, as I hope you'll see in a minute if we get a look at that report. But you must remember that this is going to be an eerie atmosphere tonight, because it is a stadium that they're used to having an enormous great crowd. It's a huge stadium, as you can see behind me. And there's just going to be maybe 20,000, if they're lucky, I would think. That's the official estimate. I would be surprised if there's even that many. So it's going to be an odd sort of atmosphere, and not the kind of atmosphere that Leeds wanted and that helped them so much at Elland Road last week.
OK, well, we can, in fact, bring you that that report now, which actually shows you all the things with the fans. But just before we do that, Nick, I suppose I said it's a very exciting. Have you seen many of our lads and lasses over there? Are they dancing in the streets, or?
Yes, one or two of them are, but they're getting here only now. Even as we speak, outside the stadium, those coaches are arriving now, and some of them have travelled 26, 28 hours overland. They leave 2 hours after the game, and they go straight back again. It's real dedication for you.
Right, Nick, thank you very much, and we can, in fact, now really bring you that report about all those fans over there in Barcelona.